Hello students, welcome to the class. Today we will discuss about the polysaccharides. In previous session we completed about the structural expression of glucose and fructose. Today we will discuss about polysaccharides. So before that we will complete the oligosaccharides, after that polysaccharides. First we will go through the oligosaccharides. So what are meant by oligosaccharides? Carbohydrates which produces more than one unit of monosaccharide units are known as the oligosaccharides. More than one means you will get 2 to 9 units of carbohydrate units. Carbohydrate units. So oligosaccharides are the carbohydrates which produces 2 to 9 units of carbohydrates. Example for oligosaccharides: sugar. Sugar, you can say that as a sucrose. When this sucrose is hydrolyzed in presence of water, in presence of acidulated water, we will get glucose and fructose. We will get the glucose and fructose. Another maltose. When maltose is hydrolyzed in presence of diastase enzyme, we will get 2 glucose units. This is the first glucose unit and this one is the second glucose unit. Another oligosaccharide is lactose. This lactose also known as milk sugar because milk contains lactose sugar. When this one undergoes hydrolysis, acetylated hydrolysis, we will get 1 galactose unit and 1 glucose unit. So these are the 3 examples. Now we are going to discuss how these glucose units are connected with fructose, how 2 glucose units are connected with each other, how galactose and glucose units are connected with each other in case of oligosaccharides. First we will begin from sucrose. Sucrose on hydrolysis, we are getting 1 glucose unit and 1 fructose unit. This is glucose unit and this one is fructose. This is sucrose. chemical activity of this sucrose is plus 66.5 degrees. Plus means dextrorotatory. Optical activity of this sucrose is plus 66.5, means sucrose is a dextrorotatory. When to this sucrose, when water is added, we are getting the sucrose solution. In sucrose solution, we have glucose particles and fructose molecules. Optical activity of this glucose is 52.5 degrees. Optical activity of fructose is minus 92.4 degrees. Minus means this fructose is levorotatory. Okay, glucose is dextrorotatory, fructose is levorotatory, sucrose is dextrorotatory. Sucrose in solid state, it is a dextrorotatory. But when it is dissolved in water, it is giving a glucose molecule and a fructose molecule. Glucose molecule optical activity is plus 52.5 degrees. Fructose molecule optical activity is minus 92.54 degrees. What happens to the net optical activity? 52.5 minus 92.4 by 2. It comes as 20, minus 20. This is the minus 20. Means in sugar solution, net optical activity is minus 20. Net optical activity is minus 20. Sucrose is dextrorotatory, but the sucrose solution is levorotatory. If we are getting minus sign here. Okay? Sucrose is dextrorotatory. When it is in solid form, it is dextrorotatory. When this sucrose is dissolved in water, we are getting optical activity as minus 20, means it becomes levorotatory. We can say that is from dextrorotation we are getting the levorotation solution. Solid is dextrorotatory, we are getting the levorotatory solution. Means what is happening here? Optical activity become reverse, inverse. Hence this sucrose is called inverse sugar. Sucrose is called inverted sugar. So what is inverted sugar? Sucrose is dextrorotatory, but aqueous solution of sucrose is levorotatory, and its optical activity is minus 20 degrees. Means optical activity become reverse. Hence sucrose is known as the inverted sugar. Okay. Next we will look at how these glucose molecules and fructose molecules are connected with each other. In glucose, in sucrose, we have alpha D glucose, and the fructose is beta D fructose. These two molecules are connected with a glycosidic bonding. Now I am drawing the structure of this, how these glucose and fructose are connected in sucrose. Glucose molecules are represented in pyranose form. Glucose molecules are represented in pyranose form. Glucose molecules are represented in pyranose form. This is glucose molecule. It is represented in a pyranose form. And this one is fructose. This one is the fructose. I am drawing alpha D glucose. D means last but one carbon, OH2 is at the right hand side. Alpha. Alpha means at right hand side. First carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon. This is the sixth carbon. So OH right side alpha D glucose. This is alpha D glucose. H. This is the hemiacetal bonding. This is hemiacetal bonding. The fifth bond carbon have hydrogen. This is alpha D glucose. Now look at beta D fructose. This is anomeric carbon. In this anomeric carbon, this anomeric carbon is bonded with OH group. This one is also attached with O. So this is first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon. Here the sixth carbon is there, CH2OH. This first carbon. This first carbon OH group, taking this is the first carbon OH group. From this side I am drawing, I am taking the numbering from this side. Okay, so that it becomes somewhat convenient to me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this is the 6th carbon. So here one OH group is there. Second carbon is make a bond with none here. H. Second carbon make a bond with 5th carbon. These are anomeric carbon. So this is the fructose unit. In sucrose, glucose first carbon make a bond with the fructose second carbon. Like this. This bond is called as glycosidic bonding. This bond is called as glycosidic bond. So in sucrose, the alpha D glucose and beta D fructose are connected with an 1-2 linkage. Glucose first carbon. Glucose first carbon is going to bonded with fructose second carbon with oxygen. That bond is called glycosidic linkage. So I am writing here in sucrose glucose C1 make bonded with oxygen with C2 of fructose. So what kind of fructose this one? This is beta D fructose and this one is alpha D glucose. So this is the structure of sucrose. In sucrose, alpha D first carbon of alpha D glucose make bond with second carbon of beta D fructose. This is the sucrose structure. They are going to ask you this part. This is the structure. Okay. So in sucrose, what kind of bondings are present and where these bondings are observed? Alpha D glucose, C1 of first carbon of alpha D glucose make bonding with the C2 of beta D fructose. And we get the sucrose. So this is about sucrose. Now look at another oligosaccharide, and that one means maltose. Have to look at whether it is a reduced sugar or non-reduced sugar. So in sucrose, first carbon of glucose make a bond with second carbon of fructose. The first carbon of glucose contains CHO group. If CHO is present, it is going to reduce. That means if CHO group is free, then that carbohydrate become reducing sugar. But here in glucose, the first carbon CHO group is in contact with fructose. So the first carbon is not free, hence sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. If this C1 carbon is free, then sucrose becomes reducing sugar. Now look at the maltose. This maltose is obtained from starch. Starch. Influence of diastase enzyme. Undergoes dissociation to give maltose. The formula of maltose is C12H22O11. This maltose, again on hydrolysis, acid hydrolysis will yield glucose ions. Maltose contains two glucose units. All these two glucose units are alpha D glucose unit. This one is alpha D glucose. How these two alpha D glucoses are connected? Glucose units are represented in pyranose. This is one of the glucose pyranose unit, and this one is another glucose pyranose unit. this glucose, this is alpha D glucose. I am not drawing all the on the atom, all the groups attached to these carbons. Simply, I am showing the pyrrolose rings. This is alpha D glucose. This one is beta D glucose. This is the first glucose unit alpha. This is the first glucose unit. First carbon. This is the second glucose unit, first carbon. The first glucose unit, first carbon is going to bonded with second glucose unit, fourth carbon. So, first carbon of alpha D glucose. First carbon of alpha D glucose made a glycosidic bonding with fourth carbon of alpha D glucose. Here the first carbon CH what group become? Here the first carbon, here we can see the OH group here, alpha D OH group free. That means this aldehyde group of the first carbon is free. So this sugar maltose is a reducing sugar. Maltose is a reducing sugar. So alpha D glucose of first glucose unit, sorry, first carbon of alpha D glucose make bonding with fourth carbon of another alpha D glucose in maltose. About the maltose. In this maltose, one of the first carbon CH2 unit make the bond involved in bond formation. But in second unit, the CH2 unit is free. Hence, this maltose become a reducing sugar. So, maltose is a reducing sugar. Next, come to the another oligosaccharide, and that one is lactose. When lactose undergoes dissociation, we will get an beta D galactose and beta D glucose. Lactose on dissociation, we will get the beta D galactose and beta D glucose. This beta D galactose and beta D glucose units are connected with C1 and C4 linkages. C1 of first carbon of galactose make a glycosidic bond with C4 of glucose. First carbon of galactose make a bond with fourth carbon of glucose. So this is about different types of oligosaccharides. Look at another point. Here what happened in this, here the glycosidic bonding is with C4 carbon, means C1 carbon. CHO group is free. First carbon CHO group is free. It is this CHO group in the form of OH, and this CHO group is in the form of cyclic. It is involved in cyclic cycle formation. So you can't observe the CHO group. If CHO, if first carbon of glucose is not involved in bond formation, if first carbon of glucose is not involved in any other bond formation, formation, glycosidic part formation. Then consider that carbohydrate as a reducing sugar. Okay. If first carbon of glucose does not involved in glycosidic bond formation, like this bond formation, then consider that sucrose and consider that carbohydrate as reducing sugar. Now I will show you all these things in the form of pyramid rings, atomic structures. This is galactose unit, and this one is glucose unit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in this sixth carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and this is the sixth carbon. This galactose unit, first carbon, is main bonding with glucose unit, first carbon. Galactose unit, first carbon, main the bonding with glucose unit, first carbon. So the first carbon of this glucose is free. The first carbon of this glucose is free. This glucose first carbon make the glycosidic linkage. This first carbon of glucose involved in glycosidic linkage. But this glucose unit, first carbon, does not involved in any kind of glycosidic linkage. This carbon CHO group is considered as free. So due to this carbon, due to this free CHO group containing carbon, this lactose become reducing sugar. So in disaccharides, glucose only. In oligosaccharide, sucrose only the non-reducing sugar. Remaining disaccharides are reducing sugars. Why sucrose is not a non-reducing sugar? Because in sucrose, the first carbon is make the bonding with the second carbon of fructose. So all the functional group containing carbons are involved in glycosidic bond formation. Hence, sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. So this is about oligosaccharides. In this carbohydrates, we have another topic, and that one is polysaccharides. We will discuss that one in the next class. For this class, it is over. Thank you.